Welcome back to my channel. If you don't know who I am or what my mission is, I basically am a diabetic teenager who is trying to create an awareness and share experiences. So today I'm going to show you how to change the infusion sets of the pump 780G and the sensor of it. So let me show you the materials. Here we have infusion sets, insulin flacon, and attachment apparatus, which is helping us to attach the infusion sets into the body. First, we take the insulin flacon and we press air into it, approximately to 2 and 3 level. Then we turn it upside down. Then we press and we apart the insulin flacon. Then we press the air into it. Then we again turn it to upside downwards. Then we press insulin in it. And I check the injector if there is any air bubble left in the insulin. And if we are sure there is no, so we may take this part off. And then by turning this part, we may take this part off. Now we have to open the infusion set to connect the injector with it. And now I open the cable and connecting it with the injector. It's okay. And we have to sense the click sound to be sure if it's okay or not. And you have to press this button and slide here. And you may see the insulin with the infusion set symbol. Then we're pressing again this button. And it asks if we want to start a new reservoir. And we're pressing again this button. Now you have to wait until it shows another screen. And by the time I'm getting off the old infusion set for my body. Now we're getting off the old injector and putting the new injector into the pump. You have to turn it for a couple times until you sense the click sound. And now I am doing the in and out move to make sure it's not falling. After doing all these steps, you're going to press hard and long to the middle button again. Now you have to see the drops. Again, we're doing the in and out move and trying to get off the white parts. And then press the middle button to open the pump and then do these steps. So now we're going to take off the sensor and I'm going to show you the steps of it. So here we have the sensor. We have transmitter here. Now, first of all, we're going to take it off. Kinda hurts. But anyways. So here we took off the sensor with the transmitter. This is transmitter. We're going to first clean it. Then we're going to charge it for an hour. So now we're trying to take off the transmitter from the sensor to clean it and to charge it afterwards.
now we are trying to take off the sensor. Here we have the sensor, and this is the transmitter.
This is the old sensor that we took off a couple minutes ago.
So we have an apparatus here, and we are going to put it in here because we are going to clean the transmitter, and we don't want any water to pass in it. Oh, you have to hear the click sound,
and also you have to see that green light there. Now we are cleaning it.
We cleaned it with wet napkin. Now we are going to dry it with a normal napkin. Now, if you're totally sure that it's clean, you can take this apparatus off. Like this, and connect it with this. Make sure your hand is straight and transmitter is straight. Make sure you're in a hard and straight place and make your transmitter horizontal, and then you can press it into the charger. That's what it did. You may see a green light here. This means it's being charged. Now you have to wait for an hour. So bye. So it have almost been 1 hour, and you can see there is no light here. Now we took our equipment to bands. This is our sensor, this is our attachment apparatus, and this is the transmitter with the charger. Now we are cleaning the skin of the upper arm to make sure that it is clean. So now we are opening the sensor. Make sure that you put the sensor onto a hard and straight place. And now take your attachment apparatus. Now place the apparatus to the upper arm and press the green buttons together in the same time. Then take the apparatus back slowly. Now we have our sensor on our body. Stick the band.
Now, take the pump. It will ask you if you want to start another sensor.
And you have to press the middle button.